Hey, World Vision fans, welcome back to another episode of Friday Free Thinking. What do I have in my hand? This is about a $200 toy if you're getting it on the secondary market. I got it luckily for less than that, but to me, the price tag is more than worth it because to me, this thing has value. Now, if I was holding something else in my hand, how about this? Fish oil. Something perhaps a lot of us take every single day. Now to you or to me, this may have a little bit more value than other people who take consideration in purchasing fish oil, because perhaps you and me, we figured we are valuing our health way more than the money we're spending to get this item. So what is the point of all this, you ask? Well, in today's episode of Friday Free Thinking, I want to discuss the topic of value and how it affects world divisions. Now, as I mentioned before, if you enjoy things that are important to you, you're gonna place a higher value than someone who pretty much don't care about Transformer toys or fish oil. Now, how does this actually translate into War of Divisions? Simple. Each of us log into the game every single day, hopefully, and play this game, and we wanna gain as much as possible from the game. So for some of us, we think of the term value essentially directly tied into our resources, while others were thinking of perhaps different sorts of value, like sentimental value or nostalgic value. No matter how you look at the word value, today's topic conversation, I just want to cover the general scope of the word value in War of Divisions. When we're thinking of term value, we think of the most bang for our buck or the most items or achievement achieved from spending the least amount of money, perhaps. And that's pretty much the basic concept of value. When you're staring at the shop like I am right now, I look at this and it says 85% off. That sounds like a great value to me because, well, if I was spending money in this game and I was looking for something like the key challenge item, then of course to me this seems like a good deal. And obviously the folks who are behind advertising these packs are trying their best to give us a sense of value, because 85% off, well, you're not gonna find this deal anywhere else, even though technically speaking, if you're not looking for this thing, it has absolutely no value. I think it goes without saying, value is in the eye of the beholder, but is it really though? I think it's easy for me to try to convince you, the viewership, that it's easy to spend something on a pack. For example, I always advertise the fact that if you're spending resources, which in this game are gonna be your gold, your visiors, your energy, and most importantly, your time, you're gonna think of things that I perhaps feel like you should buy for your resources. For example, I've always emphasized that if you see a pack that only costs gold, it's something you should go in on. And I think it makes the most sense because you can essentially exchange energy and time for more gold in which you can buy these items from the game. But unfortunately, visitors is a different concept because everybody tends to value visitors perhaps a little bit more, especially the free-to-play players, simply because you have a very limited amount of those resources. Unless, of course, you become a spender, and then in which case you're gonna start looking at the word paid. Now, when it comes to value in real life, we tend to place things that are gonna have more importance or more priority in our life. For example, food, shelter, water, essentially your basic necessities are gonna be your number one reason why you're gonna be spending your hard-earned dollars. Now, when it comes down to value in War of Divisions, I think it varies drastically. Now, I talked about what you see in the shops, and that's obvious. And for most of us, it should be obvious. If you feel like you need to buy something on a splurge or a whim, then go for it. But for the most of us, we're probably spending a lot of time planning and saving. And this is probably why Should You Save or Should You Summon videos that I've done in the past are very, very popular. Now, when we look at more things in War of Divisions, such as units, most likely we don't think of too much of term value. But I'm here to tell you, there is a lot of value to be had here. First and foremost, If you're looking at my main account, you see that I built a lot of limited time units. To a lot of folks, those units perhaps have sentimental value or perhaps nostalgic value. A lot of these characters that I decided to spend money on makes perfect sense on those realms. Now, I think I'm gonna save that topic of conversation for a different day in terms of nostalgic and obviously personal values. But here, I'm gonna only talk about what I feel like you guys should be doing in terms of building units. Now, the most important thing for me in this game is tank. And tanking in general for me is important because, well, almost every aspect of the game asks for it. Now, a lot of you guys actually have told me specifically, you don't wanna follow my channel because I love tanks. I don't know how to convince you otherwise, but the more and more I play RPGs, I realize tanking is way more important than perhaps straight out just damage. Now, I think the term value can be used very efficiently in terms of building units here. If you're to build a Warrior of Light, the chances of utilizing him in different aspects of the game is perhaps much greater than if you simply went with a straight out attacker, such as perhaps, say, Victoria, right? Now, Victoria does have some little bit of aspect to her that could help you on your team. She has a little bit of, say, debuffing or you know, status effect ailment stuff. But ultimately, her goal on the team is perhaps just to do damage. The fact that she has less HP, less defense, less spirit, and less other stats could potentially give her to, well, sacrificed in certain aspects of the game. But when you take somebody like Warrior of Light into combat, he has high HP, he has high defense, and he can be built in terms of perhaps even tanking magic. He's gonna get a lot more attention in terms of PvE or maybe even PvP content. As you guys know, hatred in this game is very important because in order to establish aggressiveness against enemy units, he needs to be able to have a lot of hatred. Therefore, the enemy units can concentrate their fire on your tank, thus leaving your attackers, perhaps even your supporting units, to do some extra damage to clear the situation. And the same situation also actually applies to PvP. Now, we know there's three types of PvP in this game. We have Guild Wars, we have Arena, and of course we have Match Play. Now, in terms of building units, it's important to think of the term value because, well, how many of those things can you cover when you're thinking of building a unit? The same concept can be actually applied to equipment, vision cards, and of course, espers. I call those three the trifecta. A lot of folks are starting to call those three the trinity because they're realizing that those three have a humongous impact on your account. Value here could be a little bit more subjective. Some people treat raids, well, with a lot of animosity because of the fact that it's very hard, it's very grueling, and it takes a lot of time. Remember I said that time is perhaps one of your most valuable resources. So deciding to spend that resource to exchange for something like, say, a +5 platinum robe has to be decided ultimately by the player and obviously how much time they can allocate to those dedicated events. My personal suggestion, obviously, when it comes to UR equipment would be perhaps look at the actual equipment and see if they give you the most bang for your buck. This way, it will give you perhaps the ultimate value. And the easiest way to do that is look at how many jobs can actually equip it. Wow, that one obviously you saw a lot of jobs can equip it. So therefore, perhaps that is something you could concentrate on building versus something that perhaps are a little bit more niche. Whereas if you decided to look at something else that's more restrictive to say classes such as a spear or a lance, perhaps that's something definitely more of a niche. If you don't enjoy piercing, maybe you should just avoid those events altogether. Now, in terms of Esper, it's a little bit more convoluted because these little creatures all have a grid system. And the grid system, well, is so flexible in the sense that you can do whatever you want. Sometimes all it takes is a little extra visiors to reset the panel so you can actually build it for specific situations. Personally, I don't think we're there yet where encounters are difficult enough for us to sit there and reset the board over and over, thus costing you, well, a lot of your resources. But I think when you're considering building espers, you don't necessarily need to build every single one. And the reason being is because, well, you can build one specifically to cover a wide variety, or as I like to call it, an umbrella. For example, if you build an Odin, every single unit in this game can actually be attached with resonance to Odin simply because this one offers a lot of agility and the Esper board offers Man-Eater, which is one of the most common units in the game that you'd be going up against. So it makes total sense to go all in, full investment in something like Odin. Whereas other units, a little bit niche. For example, if you're to go with, say, Titan, most likely you're probably going to be building this for resistances, such as Wind, which is very niche, of course, or straight up Piercing Attack plus Spirit Up. This is obviously, again, as I referred to the lances and spears of this game, is also very niche. Currently, we do not have too many units that actually can utilize this Esper. So, spending too many resources to build this thing up, perhaps is going to be something up to you in terms of how your preferences are. Obviously, the last part of the trifecta is going to be vision cards. And vision cards, I think, is truly where you're going to see a lot of niche situations. You see that fire attack resistance is essentially targeting something very specific. So is this card worth investing in? Because people can say, well, this card is pretty low rarity. You shouldn't have no problem building it. However, this game is actually very, very cruel when it comes to enhancing your vision cards because it eats up a lot of your resources. Remember I said gold is one of your most powerful resources? Well, I'm not lying. Let's take a look at this. If I was to enhance a different card, it takes a lot of gold. As you can see, if I max it, that's 4 million. Plus, you can see it's already drained roughly 25% of all my golden eggs. That is a lot of resources to be earned because the game simply does not just give you resources up the wazoo. You have to make very crucial decisions when it comes to investing in certain things in this game. Therefore, your goal is to try to build things that can cover, like I said before, the umbrella. Therefore, you can cover more situations for the least amount of investments done. Remember I talked about Odin the Esper? Well, we're at it again with Odin the Vision card. Unit attack resistance up is essentially covering almost anything in this game because everything is in unit. Man-Eater, as I said before, is so common that having the bestowed effect is never going to harm you. And unit attack resistance, essentially, you can take it almost anywhere in the entire game. So in my opinion, Odin will have a lot of value. Okay, so I think that's all the time for this video. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Friday Free Thinking. Because I think I never really thought about value as much as I'm thinking about it now. Because as we're approaching 1 year anniversary, I feel like going forward after that is more important to think about things that you really want to build rather than just looking at your box and says, I want to build them all. Because honestly speaking, you can't. And it shouldn't be advised by any content creator to tell players to build everything that they come across their path. So remember, time is your most valuable resource, so spend it wisely. Until next time, take care of yourself and all your loved ones. Nashtaters and his family out of here. Have a great weekend. Peace.